Hello and welcome everyone. And now I'm starting very important section in JavaScript, which is the object creation. What are the different ways in which you can create the object and inherit the object, and what is the difference between them? You know, we can create the object like this, var p1 equal to new object. Okay, we can create the new object from the existing object, var p1 equal to, there is some object you have passed like person object, right? Then there is another way is var p3 equals to object.create, right, where you can pass the existing object. Okay, and another thing is var p4, where you pass object.prototype or function.prototype, right? So these are the four different ways of creating an object. Like here we are extending the properties also. Object.create, it is creating the object from existing object person here also. So we'll talk all these four one by one. What is the difference? What is the difference when I do something like this? What is the difference when I do something like this? Is both are same? Yes, both are same. If you just talk about the x.proto and x1.underscore_proto, both will be the same. If you just do x.underscore_proto, it is equals to x1.underscore_proto. Both are same, right? So we'll talk about in the same semantics. Okay, so I created p1 and p2 from the object function. Object is a function. If you do the type of and when you do the object, this is a first class function, right? Everything in JavaScript is a first class function. Type of object is a function. I'm creating two objects, p1 and p2, right? So what is the difference? What I'm doing here is I created two objects, p1 and p2. These will be the empty object. If you do console.log, then you will get an empty object from it. Now p1 and p2, right? So if you do p1 and p2, obviously they are pointing to the different memory location, so you will not get the value. I need to do the complete selection to execute this. It will be false, right? What p1.prototype is pointing to? p1.prototype, p1 is created from the object, right? So p1.prototype will be undefined and p1.proto will be empty object, because p1 and p2 both are created from the object. So proto of p1 and p2 will be pointing to the capital O object.prototype. Okay, so object.prototype is empty. So you see this, I will execute this complete and then I will talk about one by one why and how this is working. So object.prototype dot proto. So whenever you do the proto on capital O object, obviously it will point to the null because there is nothing above capital O object. P1, it is an object which is created from the capital O object. So its proto will point to the object.prototype. Then again proto will point to the null. Okay. P1.proto, this p1.proto is pointing to the object.prototype. That is correct because we are creating the p1 from the object constructor function. Then object.proto is an empty object and p1.underscore_proto and p2.underscore_proto will be different. So p1.proto and p2.proto both are pointing to the object prototype. Let's see what we will get. So we are getting true, right? Because p1 is also created from the capital object. P2 is also created from capital O object, and both are pointing to the object prototype. If I do this, what you will get? This is pointing to the empty object, which is capital O object.prototype. So if we try to represent this in the diagram, what actually we are doing? Try to take a look onto this. It's very important. P1 and P2. P1 and P2 both are false. Object.prototype is an empty object. P1.proto is pointing to the object.prototype. P1.proto and proto is null. Okay. So this is object.prototype, and we have created two object P1 and P2, because P1 proto and P2 property both are pointing to object prototype. And if you do proto again on object.prototype, obviously it will be null because there is nothing above it. So there is a function object in JavaScript. We creating the new object from this capital O object, because we wrote new object means here we are actually creating constructor function object P1. So this is the prototype, and this proto is pointing to P1. This proto is pointing to the P2. So P2_proto will point to the object prototype. Object is a function here, and its proto is pointing to null. So this is the first way of creating the object. And whenever we do var p1 equal to empty parenthesis, that is also doing the same thing. Okay, and this is very important part. So I think this is clear now. Object is a function, and we are creating the two object p1 and p2 from that constructor function. That and proto will be pointing to the object prototype, and that further proto will be null. Okay. Let's talk about in the next video the extension of it.